You're not going to want to miss this episode of the AI Show, where we look at something that all of you use. A little hint, the squiggles underneath are produced by some amazing AI from the Office team. Make sure you tune in. Hello and welcome to this episode of the AI Show, where we're going to talk a little bit about some of the stuff that you use all of the time and how it actually works. I have Anirudh and Krutart with me. How are you doing, my friends?
Good. How are you?
Why don't you introduce yourselves, tell us who you are and what you do.
Cool. I'm Anirudh. I'm a data scientist on Office Intelligence, and I work on the red and blue underlines that you see in Word pretty much all the time.
Fantastic.
I'm an applied scientist on Natural Language Experience Group as well. We build machine learning models that help people write better.
So tell us what it is that you actually do, because you work on something that everyone uses and that's supposed to help us, at least help me because I'm terrible at English. Tell us what you do.
Sure. So on a daily basis, what we do is we train NLP models using some of the latest neural architectures to help understand the context of your text in order to give you the right grammar and spelling corrections that you need.
So when I'm typing, usually there's like a little some colored bar that says you should fix it. I feel like you were going to say something.
Yeah, so what I was saying that we are building machine learning models and making sure that we try to augment the writing experience of users, but not step on the boundaries and try to kind of be more of a intrusive experience for
users. So just you're trying to help out, be like, hey, it might be good to change your wording this way as opposed to here, I'm going to rewrite this.
Yeah.
So how many people use this? I feel like I use it all the time.
Yeah, I mean, our monthly active users are in the tens of millions. So it's, you know, very widely used service. And essentially at the core, we're an intelligent writing assistant. So when you as a writer come and use our service, we want you to just focus on getting your ideas on the on Word or any Office app. But at the end of the day, all the polishing stuff should be on us. And we'll help you polish your document as need be.
So generally what I do is I just, like if I'm trying to be like super proactive about writing, I just start writing and like get the ideas all out. You're saying that in Word in the editor, you're just going to make sure to polish it as it goes.
Exactly. Yes.
That's pretty amazing. So let's get into the machine learning part because this is obviously the AI show. This must be some crazy model that you're building. Can you describe a little bit about like what it is that you're, how you're building it? Maybe describe a little bit for those that are out there watching.
Sure, yeah. So editor initially had rule-based systems, and in recent years, we are trying to augment it with machine learning and deep learning models. And so all these models, they are huge models, as you already know, and they are usually trained for days on the on end. And so, yeah, they are RNN-based, LSTM-based models.
So these are just neural networks, standard, like RNNs, LSTMs.
Yes.
But I imagine that like you have a lot of data to train it on. I mean, can you give everyone a sense of the scale of the data that you're training with?
Yeah, I mean, so it's definitely large for an NLP scenario. You know, these are tens and tens of millions of sentences. So the corpus has to be big in order for us to make sure we suggest grammatically accurate rewrite.
And is this text coming from books, or where is it coming from that you're training on?
So we are training on public available data, but we are getting some user signals as well, whether user accepted or ignored our suggestion, and use that to augment our models.
And the important thing to know is that, you know, Microsoft, we care a lot about privacy.
Absolutely.
So anytime, you know, user signals are used, they're done in a totally eyes-off fashion. So there's definitely, like, from a data science perspective, user privacy is treated as the utmost priority.
Yeah.
So we do try as much as possible to train on public corpuses. Mm-hmm. You know, Google billion word corpus, Wikipedia text. These are large corpuses used for natural language processing training.
Where we hope the English is good.
Exactly. Yeah.
And you were going to say something?
I was just going to add on that eyes off mean we don't look at the data at all.
Yeah. I mean, it's very important. I mean, like, cognitive services the same way. We don't use people's data. We have stuff that's publicly available, and then if there are signals that we send back, nobody knows about any of that. So let's talk about, again, can you give us a sense of the like the amount of data? Is it like gigabytes, terabytes, bajillion bytes?
It's hundreds of millions of sentences.
So obviously this is not going to fit in RAM, so the size of the VM you're using must be ginormous.
No, Seth. So actually, fortunately for us, we use Azure Machine Learning.
Okay.
So what that enables us to do is we can train on hundreds of GPUs simultaneously, so we can distribute our training workloads using Azure ML.
So let's get into this like in the engineering, because I love machine learning specifically. I love doing deep learning. I'm more of a vision guy, but I imagine you must be using some framework.
Yeah, so we use PyTorch, which has become state of the art for most deep learning tasks.
So when you're using PyTorch, how do you, like, cause look, the way I understand it is that you give it some data and then you run through a number of batches, and then once you go through all the data, you're done with an epoch. Like, how do you do this with so much data? Distributed fashion.
It's almost as easy as you train on a single VM. Okay. You just specify the number of VMs, and then we use Horovod, which takes care of all the distribution on the Azure Machine Learning platform, and you can just run jobs on 100 VMs, 1,000 VMs, without even worrying about it. And when they are all done, Azure Machine Learning helps to bring all the results together, and you don't even see that you have run the job on 1,000 VMs.
I see. So you're using Azure Machine Learning Service. Do you have like a sneaky special workspace that no one else has, or is it just a regular one?
No, it's the same.
It's the same. Everyone else can use.
All right, let's go to the screen here. So we are looking here at your workspace where you train this.
Exactly. Yeah.
Yes.
And this is the same one that anyone else can start up.
Absolutely.
With.
Exactly.
So let me see if I'm understanding this right, because I want to make sure I clarify. Because I know PyTorch, I know how to run it. I've seen some examples with Horovod. You add a couple of things.
Exactly.
A couple of lines, and then you just say run it.
Yep.
Yeah, you just add your subscription ID, a few other details, and specify how many number of nodes you want to use, and then just click run. And it dynamically spins up a cluster, and you're good to go.
How long does this take to run?
So in order to spin up everything, it's a matter of minutes. And then after that, it's how big your model is, how big the data set is. And of course, if you want to distribute over like hundreds of GPUs, it's going to be really fast.
Are we talking like hours, days, weeks? I know there's some machine learning models that take weeks.
So
right?
Our model would have taken weeks if we didn't have Azure Machine Learning. Mm-hmm. But given that we do, we can do this in a matter of hours now.
Yeah.
Oh, snap. Yeah. They didn't tell me this before the video when we prepared. That's pretty amazing, especially over hundreds of millions of sentences.
Exactly.
Which is pretty amazing. So let's talk a little bit about the actual feature, because I want to see it in action, because it's very subtle, right, when you're doing it. So let's go to the screen one more time and see what it is that it's actually doing.
Sure. So initially, I'm sure people have been using Word for a decade now, and these are some of the grammar rules that they may have seen while using Word, things like resolve your subject verb disagreement, or even like punctuation errors like add a hyphen.
Yeah.
So without machine learning, it was possible to do some of those grammar corrections, but in order to do some of the more complicated linguistic corrections, we need to understand the context of the sentence.
Sure.
So that's where our AI capabilities come in.
For instance, in this sentence, it's kind of very easy to miss an article. Uh-huh. When you write a sentence, I have apple and you have banana, but our model, if you go and it shows that, oh, you need to add an article there.
I see. Right, because now, because usually if with rules-based things, because that's what it was previously,
yes.
And you still do rule-based, but now you've augmented with AI, it's hard to add text.
Yes.
It's easy to see where things might be wrong,
yeah.
But not to get the sequence, which sequence models are super good at,
yeah.
Right?
Exactly.
It's kind of a clickware mechanism with rule-based system.
And that's really cool. And so, like, as I'm writing this stuff, I could just like spill the ideas out in my uncluttered fashion, and then the editor will go ahead and say, here's some rules that might be broken, augmented with some AI that we've
created
on the machine learning service.
And Seth, one thing I do want to stress too is like, there's some people who are coming from languages that don't necessarily use articles in their language. And when they try to write English, they make these mistakes a lot. So this is a way for us to, help them also sound a lot more professional when they write their documents.
That's pretty amazing. So a couple more questions, if I may. How are you getting all these hundreds of millions of sentences into the distributed things that are running in Azure Machine Learning Service? How does it know where to look, or where is it getting that data from?
So that data is something that we have to, as data scientists, have to curate and make sure we have on like Azure Blob Storage.
Okay.
Our machine learning compute will point to that Blob Storage in order to distribute across.
I see. Yeah. So you don't have to like download the data to each machine, because hundreds of millions of sentences, that's a ginormous text file. We don't
it's
want
just
that.
An unstructured data store, uh-huh. Where you can store images, you can store audio, you can store text.
And then Azure Machine Learning Service will mount it to these VMs
exactly.
that are running
exactly.
in the service mesh. Yeah. This is pretty amazing. Where can people go to find out more about this?
So we have an Office AI blog, which talks specifically about Editor. And that's a place where people can go to find out more. Also, the Azure Machine Learning Service is on a lot of Azure blogs, and that's where they can find out like how to use this service for their own projects.
Awesome. We'll put some links below, obviously. You were going to say something?
That was specific Azure Machine Learning blog.
Oh, fantastic. Yeah. I'm pretty impressed. And the thing that's cool is that it feels like we just don't make things. We actually use the things that we make for some of the products around it. So it feels pretty cool to see that. Because when I looked at the workspace, this is the one that I've been working with all the time, like doing MNIST over and over again. Very sorry. This is a real, actual problem that maybe would have taken weeks and now down to hours. And when we say this in machine learning, for those that are just like, hey, I want to be an AI person, and like weeks is generally the standard amount of time to run on a real scale production model. Yeah. And now my sense is that you probably put this model out and lots of people are using it at the same time.
Absolutely.
A little machine learning thing. Now you can use Cypher 100 instead of MNIST.
Oh, there. He's giving me some tips now, so this is good. Thank you so much for spending some time with us. Thank you so much for watching. We're learning all about the enhanced AI inside of the Word Editor. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you next time. Take care.